The cosmos is a dark, endless expanse of celestial phenomenon. That's pretty much a given. Out there, somewhere in the vast depths of space, gargantuan, scorching spheres of pure magma burn incessantly. Mind-bending, galaxy-swallowing black holes twist and turn, collapsing upon themselves into infinity. Entire clusters of molecules and matter collide endlessly, forging planets out of their respective galaxies across millennia in the eternal hotspot and hive of activity that we happily call our mysterious and wondrous universe. There's a lot going on, and more importantly, a lot of stuff that generates energy. And although we may take it for granted, it indeed poses the question, who turned out all the lights? Well, let's find out. Hello internet, what's going on? And once again, welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as today we curiously ask the question, what if the universe was white? Roll the clip. Alright guys, fair enough, that's probably much more translucent gold than it is blinding white, but hey, that's what you get when you hire the Nova Corps to try and visually depict your life's biggest question, isn't it? Although we do have to salute those brave, brave star pilots for saving Xander. Thank you guys. Either way, for the curious amongst you, that scene was of course from 2014's Guardians of the Galaxy, because hey, this is a video about the universe, and light or no light, someone needs to protect it. But yeah, that's probably a story for a different time. First off, we have to approach this question and clarify exactly what we mean by white, because when we say that, what we really mean is light, a bright white light, to be exact, a light that is everywhere, all at once, constantly, forever. Ever since our galaxy burst into the dazzling brilliance of existence after everything went bang, our universe gradually became populated by the burning solar suns of their respective system, which now make up the endless expanse of stars that we can happily see on a clear, romantic night with our best friends and all loved ones. Now, there are about 10 billion galaxies in our observable universe alone, and although the number of stars in each galaxy varies, it's safe to assume that there's a tentative average of 100 billion stars per galaxy. If we take that as a given, that means there are around 1 billion trillion stars in our observable universe, and if you couldn't tell already, that's a lot. And it's also important to note that each of those stars pump out a wildly varying degree of energy through heat. The surface of a red star, which is often seen as the coolest, still pumps out about 5,000 degrees Fahrenheit. Our sun, which is a yellowish white on the surface, pumps out about 10,000 degrees Fahrenheit. And the hottest stars in the universe, which are blue, can be as hot as 200,000 degrees Fahrenheit at their core. That's a lot of heat, and most importantly, that's a lot of light. So, why then is our universe so damn dark? Why is it an endless void of nothingness? What's going on? Where's all that light going? Surely, with so many burning balls of magma floating in the cosmos, we should at the least be able to play our 1989 Nintendo Game Boy without buying the light accessory to go with it, right? Well, here's the thing, and here's where the technical parameters of our particular hypothetical notion earn a little bit of their credibility. Because most importantly, when we are referring to the visible spectrum of light waves, the dark blackness of our universe is not a color, but instead it is the absence of color, the absorption of the visible spectrum that we perceive as light. You see, as far as physics is concerned, although the backdrop of our cosmos is the absorption of this light, the universe has already been white before, albeit a bright, dazzling, brilliant white light, if only for a fraction of an instance. In the chronology of the Big Bang, if we were to somehow travel back to that moment when all life sprang into existence, we would be witnessing an endless expanse of white light as the colossal energy that created literally everything, every morsel of matter that makes up your elbow and your kitchen sink, that sprang into existence. In that respect, to partly answer our question, if our universe was white, it would mean that we were experiencing the eternal moments of creation. And I hate to break it to you, but that wouldn't exactly be good, because the Big Bang tends to go, well, bang. When our universe was born from the Big Bang in the following moments of existence, it didn't have any stars around to emit light. Instead, it was a completely opaque plasma, a strange, bubbling, boiling hot soup of protons, electrons, and neutrons whirling around and trying to find their place in the universe. Literally speaking, of course. After around 300,000 years, the bubbling soup of space cooled down enough to let those protons, electrons, and neutrons get to know each other, where they created the first atoms and molecules that would pave the way for life as we know it. Still though, despite this wondrous feat of creation, it would still be absolute pitch black darkness, as not a single light source had yet formed. This was known as the Dark Age of the Universe, a stark parallel to the brilliant white light that had progenitored it. Thankfully for us though, that particular era ended with the fusion of hydrogen and helium, which led the way to the awesome universe that we know now. But to further understand exactly why the universe isn't still a dazzling white expanse of solar energy, we need to look at the most important rule in the whole of physics: starlight and the cosmic speed limit of anything and everything, the speed of light. Which, thanks to science, we know is precisely 299,792,458 meters per second. And when light became a thing, that's when the universe started doing all kinds of crazy stuff. Because of this particularly critical nugget of information, we can also know all manners of insane and mind-boggling things. For instance, we know that our galaxy, the Milky Way, is 100,000 light years across. We know to travel from Earth to our nearest neighboring galaxy, Andromeda, it would take 2.5 million light years. And from Earth to the current edge of the observable universe, it would take 46.5 billion years. If you can tell, that is quite a long time. However, that number is constantly changing, and herein lies the rub. Our universe is constantly expanding, and the time it takes for the physical limit of light to illuminate a certain portion of the night sky is what prevents the entire universe being a dazzling, endless expanse of white light. This is known as Olbers' paradox, a notion penned by the German astronomer Heinrich Wilhelm Olbers, which is a critical component in the assumption that our universe is dynamic instead of static. Because if our universe was static, as in it had stopped expanding, it would mean that our universe had already become infinitely old and infinitely big, and it had been that way forever. You see, this directly contradicts with the fact that science agrees that our universe's age is finite, the most accurate estimation being around 13.8 billion years old. However, if that was the case, as Olbers' paradox finds conflict with, it would mean that our universe would already be white, down to the fact that light had already had an infinite amount of time to shine throughout the universe, and thus making the universe white from all points of observation. In that case, if the universe was white, it would mean that our universe may also be static, and if the current scientific model is correct, that would be pretty bad, given the fact that there'd have been no evolution on any scale, and then we'd never have been around to answer this question. There we have it, our long and short answer to the question, what if the universe was white? It would mean that our universe had never expanded for infinity, and we'd more than likely not be around to do this pleasant outro. What a shame. Well, what do you guys think? Do you agree, disagree? Let us know your thoughts down in the comment section below, as well as any intriguing insights of your own. Before we depart from today's video though, if you'd like to carry on with your questioning binge, make sure to hear any one of our relevant playlists, compiled neatly for your viewing enjoyment. On that note, unfortunately that's all we've got time for in today's video. Just stick around all the way until the end. If you were a fan of this video, or just life's biggest question in general, then please be a dear and hit that thumbs up button, as well as that subscribe bell, and I'll be seeing you in the next one. As per usual, I've been your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions, and until next time, you take it easy.